We've got temperature sensors, distance sensors, magnetic field sensors.
We offer a rigorous curriculum here. The students are all engaged in pre-AP and AP classes, as well as dual credit classes. You're getting credit for your high school and your college all at the same time.
The school that they have now is in one hallway, so it makes me excited to know that it's going to be bigger.
The South Early College High School is getting a new building. Everything that's going to be necessary for those students to get into that mindset for learning for advanced technology is going to be available in that new building.
We have the mission of HISD, which is designed a 21st century school, meaning it had to be adaptable, it had to be flexible.
We were recently named a recipient of the Magnet School Assistance Program, which essentially gave us a grant to emerge as an advanced technology academy here.
The building is just going to simply accentuate the program. And so, you know, with the robotics, we actually have what we call a STEM lab where the students will be able to create robots. And, you know, they'll have the science labs that will allow them to delve into the physics and to the chemistry and the biology. So, you know, everything's going to be wired. Everything's going to be 21st century.
Access to technology has always been at the forefront of our design.
What we decided to do in this school was to create neighborhoods, which are basically smaller schools within a school. We've got three neighborhoods on the second floor and one neighborhood on the first floor. Each neighborhood is centered around a different discipline. For instance, we have one robotics lab, computer technology and software engineering, and they contain a CTE lab. They contain three learning centers, a learning commons, study rooms, and they can all be adaptable where we have operable walls that open and close to create larger spaces. We centered the building around a courtyard concept. That courtyard can be a multi-use courtyard where students can eat, or they can study, or have group activities. Centered around that courtyard, we have a lot of glazing that will allow natural light into the learning commons. We have a community room. The dining commons and multi-purpose room can be opened into one large space for over 400 people. So the community can also use that room for large functions.
I really love this new building. I think that it's based on the 21st century. It's very flexible. This is how students will learn.
The entire building was pretty state of the art. I think that the kids in the community will be excited to see something like this in our neighborhood.
We're moving forward into a truly a hub for technology learning.
It's been a lot of community involvement, and they have involved the community all along the way in terms of the design.
We can come in and kind of talk to the construction people and the architects and talk about kind of what they're putting into the building and why. You feel like you do have a voice.
Is that like for when it gets wet?
I think they really did a great job with giving us feedback on, you know, the answers that we needed.
It makes me know that they care about our opinions and what matters to us.
I really do feel like they are listening to us.
It's important to me that we get our school built and finally get a school that we can call our own.
After all, it's the students that we're building all of this for. So it's all student-centered, student-focused. It's for the students now and students of the future.